Welcome to a new Planetary and Seismic update. We look at the SGI graph from 19 to 28 March, and we see the seismic activity that occurred on the 19th and on the 20th. Very early on, we had two seismic events, 5.6, following a planetary geometry involving Venus. And as I mentioned in the previous update, we had high lunar peaks, and two of which I did not consider critical. But then we had the planetary conjunction Earth, Venus and Saturn late on the 21st and early on the 22nd. And that was followed quickly by a 6.4 magnitude earthquake. And then we see the high lunar peak in the middle. This is a conjunction or two conjunctions involving Venus and Saturn. And I specifically mentioned that lunar geometry because I considered it more critical. And indeed, we see just following that lunar peak, a 6.8 at New Guinea. And also a 5.7 early on the 24th. Other than that, we did not have considerable seismic activity or significant seismic activity. It was a relatively quiet period. I already mentioned the geometry that we're going to have from the 26th to the 28th. This is a grouping of right angle geometry involving Mercury and Venus, and that is critical. So let's have a look. Early on the 26th, it starts with a conjunction Mercury, Sun, Mars, and then we have this grouping of right angle geometry. And that deserves a bit of an explanation. And I made some illustrations to clarify this geometry. Here you see Mercury at a right angle with Venus and Uranus. And that particular geometry doesn't happen every week or every month. It happens about three or four times a year, and it usually comes in pairs. So on the other side, you see Venus at a right angle with Mercury and Uranus. This is because Mercury and Venus, they move pretty fast, close to the Sun. They have a high orbital velocity. So when they move together, they make this geometry, this right angle geometry with Uranus or another outer planet in a short time, usually within 1 or 2 days. And that's what we're going to have on 27 and 28 March. Now let's have a look at this particular geometry as it happened last year in 2023. We see the year and we see that it happened four times. That was in January, in May, July, and the end of November, early December. Now here it gets interesting. If we look at major earthquakes, magnitude 7.5 and larger last year, it happened six times. But if we consider the large earthquakes in Turkey on 6 February, a 7.8 and a 7.5 as a single event on one day, we had five major events on 5 days. And let's have a look when that actually happened. As you can see, three out of five occurred just after this right angle geometry with Mercury and Venus. It happened in early January, January 7, 8, and we had this 7.6 on the 9th in Indonesia. And in May, we had also Mercury-Venus paired in right angle geometry on the 13th and 14th, and within 5 days on the 19th, the Loyalty Islands 7.7. In July, only a mid-6 magnitude within 2 days. A seismic response, but not all that much. Again, that depends on the stress levels in Earth's crust, whether or not we're going to have this big one. And then also the end of November, early December, on 29th November and 1 December, we had also had this particular right angle geometry with Mercury and Venus. And we had the Philippines a 7.5. Three out of five. And that counts. There's this obvious relationship. And this is not just 2023, but it is recently, and it's a perfect example what this geometry actually can do. So let's go back to the SGI graph. Again, we have this grouping of right angles on the 26th, 27th, followed by the higher peaks on the 27th and 28th. And that is the particular geometry of Mercury, Venus and Uranus. And there can be a major seismic event following that geometry. And that could be 29th, 30th, maybe 31st, but around the 30th is a distinct possibility that a major seismic event is going to occur somewhere between 7.3, 7.6, 7.7 or thereabouts. But we have this grouping on the 26th, 27th, an additional grouping of right angle geometry. So be on watch, there can be major seismic activity following this geometry. If you look further, we see on the 31st also some right angle geometry, but less critical. And then on the 1st of April, Mercury, Sun, Saturn. And then on the 3rd, we see a convergence of planetary conjunctions coming up. I will discuss that in the next update, but there may be a synchronicity with the right angles. We're not sure yet, so we have to wait and see what is going to happen following these right angles with Mercury and Venus from the 26th to the 28th. But beware, there is a distinct possibility based on the statistics that there is going to be a major seismic event. We cannot say for sure that it's going to happen, but I do expect an obvious seismic increase, not just the higher 5 magnitude range, but probably well into the 6 magnitude range in the coming days, and there could be a major seismic event. Where it's going to be, we don't have we don't have atmospheric indicators at this time. We do have two on the website, and we already shared those atmospheric fluctuations, but other than that, we don't have additional atmospheric indicators right now, but when we get them, we will share them, of course. Stay safe. Until next time.